Welcome to Office Mechanics. Coming up on today's show, if you're not satisfied with your current spam filtering and looking to harden your email environment, we'll show you what you can do with the latest in advanced threat protection. We'll also take a look at new capabilities in Office 365 and Exchange Online to consistently protect you against phishing attacks with new features such as safe attachments and safe links, plus more to safeguard you against malware and bulk spamming. By Shobhit Sahai, Office 365 security expert. So what's behind these enhancements?
Thanks, Jeremy. Great to be here. So we have had protection in place for a while now with Exchange Online protection, and it continues to be an area of constant evolution. But as attackers around the globe are getting smarter, finding new ways to create sophisticated attack, we have to provide proactive defenses against such attacks, whether or not they are known or unknown.
Right, now let's take a look at this through some common attack vectors, because there are lots of things that we can do in terms of getting malware to different users. And what I want to start with is really opening up my attack surface itself in terms of sending bulk spam email. And I've got something here that will do that. So right now, if I go into a folder here that contains all of my script files, I've actually got a CSV account. I've been going through Contoso Bank ATP's user accounts, and I've got a nice list here of about 150 people that I'm going to try to hit spam with. And I'm going to use the spam users.ps1 PowerShell script that will basically send all of these different users the spam email. So what happens there? Can you protect those users against this attack?
Yes, we can. But depending on the content of the email, you might actually get through the first time. But once we know that you're a known spammer, we now have more advanced ways to blocking you, like with enhanced bulk mail protection.
So couldn't I just change the sender's email address every time I send a mail?
Well, it's actually more sophisticated than that. We don't just block your email address, we block you at the IP address level. The other thing to realize is not every bulk email is bad. Some things you want to keep, and people subscribe to their favorite service all the time. What you care about is the deceitful emails or the bulk offenders. And to help you with that, Microsoft actually works behind the scenes to evaluate bulk email messages and rates the reputation of the sender.
So how do these ratings work?
Via machine learning, where we take inputs on different things, such as IP addresses, the bulk reputation for the sender. We also look at the frequency of the mailing. And at the same time, we're also looking at other things, like whether somebody has marked that document or email as junk. And based on this, the system then figures out a classification level from a scale of 1 to 9 for the bulk messages that are coming through.
OK, so how do I take advantage of this as an Office 365 admin?
Well, as an admin, you can set up bulk classification level. Let me show you how. So on my screen here, I have a default content filtering policy. And if I try to open that, I can walk into spam and bulk email settings. Mm-hmm. And now what you will notice, we have something called as the bulk email. And here is where we can specify the threshold for our organization. By default, 7 is a threshold. And you can go up or higher, or you can go down and make a default rating of 3. The key thing here is that the higher the threshold, the more the bulk spam that can come through. The lower the threshold, the less the bulk spam that can get in.
Okay, so we've covered off spam now, but what if I then go to the next level and I say I'm going to just attack people one by one or individually? Do you have anything that can protect me better there?
Yes. At first, at a connection filtering level, we can block your IP address. So here in my Office 365 administrative console, I have a default policy where I've specified certain IPs that I've already blocked. Now, these are IPs that I know are bad, and I've definitely easily blocked them using this control. But I can't subscribe to every single bad IP. I can't, you know, manage them. So what Microsoft provides me is safe list. And this is a list of thousands of IPs that we have collected over a course of time. There are 1.7 million such IPs, and it's a growing list that continues to grow even further.
And one of the things here is, and even on the first example, I was a malicious sender trying to get bulk email out. A lot of these emails are coming through unintentional senders of bad mail. Maybe they've downloaded some files, maybe they've looked at some links. They want to forward those on to other people, and I've actually got a couple of things here set up. But what can you do in terms of helping me out there to protect unintentional senders of bad mail?
Well, that's where we have malware filtering. So here in my malware filter, I have a default policy that I've changed slightly to for my organization. So here I can specify how I want to treat such messages. If a message contains malware, I can easily delete the entire message, or I can take some more granular controls. I can say, you know what, let's delete the attachment, but let's still send the custom alert message back to the sender and the recipient. And I can also notify the administrator of the company by specifying their email address and providing a custom notification for them.
Okay, now I've got some mails actually prepared here that have malware in them. So I'm gonna go ahead and send you one. So the first one here is a bank opening form doc file. Now what's gonna happen there is it's gonna go through, and the first thing that we'll see is it will actually, as the sender, inform me that this message was automatically picked up by the malware filter that's got something bad in it. So I then know that I've got something bad I've sent to you.
Right, and it's not just you who knows that something bad has come in. I've received that same email on my inbox, and here I'm logged in with my account on Outlook, and I can clearly see that I see a message that has come from you, but instead of the same attachment that you had sent across, I now have a different attachment. And if I try to open that, I see that exact same notification that my administrator placed for this, because we found a malware in this particular message, and we have blocked it.
So this is all great for known malware, but as a lot of people know, antivirus problems in general, that it has to actually know about that malware in advance,
yep,
to be able to write signature files to know that it's there. But what happens if I've got a brand new piece of malware that's never been detected before?
Well, that's where advanced threat protection comes in, because it even protects you against the unknown threats. The first new capability is called safe attachments, and here's how it works. Now, every single message in Office 365 goes through different multiple spam filters, and it also goes through three different antivirus engines. But for any message that contains suspicious attachments, we now have a sandbox environment where each such a suspicious attachment goes through our detonation chamber, and within the detonation chamber, we are doing behavior analysis to find out whether the attachment is malicious. We are looking for machine learning things and patterns, such as, is this attachment running an executable? Is it requesting access privileges? Is it calling any of the registry keys? Mm-hmm. And based on our analysis, we can block your message, because we can say this message or this attachment is definitely suspicious. And you can easily set up a policy for your company using the safe attachment. And here, you can find that from the administrative console. We have a new filter altogether called advanced threats. And within the advanced threat protection, you can see that safe attachment policy. I've set up a policy for my organization here by default, where I can specify by default any such suspicious attachments must be blocked. So I've done that, and at the same time, any such attachments which are getting blocked, I can redirect it back to the administrator, so that he can go back and find out what exactly was blocked in that message.
Right, and I just so happen to have an email here prepared that has some brand new malware that's never been released yet. What I want to do is send you that just to see what happens after you've created this policy
right. Using
advanced threat protection. So unlike the other message, I'm not actually going to see a sender notice that I've sent something bad, but you can detect that on your end, right?
That's right. What's happening behind the scenes right now is it's that particular attachment is going through our detonation chamber. And on average, it takes about 7 to 8 minutes for us to figure out if that attachment is bad. And our SLA is about 30 minutes. What we have done previously is, because it's taking some time, we already have a notification that has come in from one of the previous emails that you had sent me. And you can clearly see here the email is coming from Exchange Online Advanced Threat Protection. So the administrator is aware that, yes, this is a malicious attachment which does not have a known signature. And at the same time, I can also see exactly what the message was. So if I try and open this particular message, I can see that you sent me an email and there were a couple of attachment files, and all of them apparently contain the unknown malware.
So even going beyond this, because I know a lot of people are thinking, okay, well, that's malware that's detected through the actual transport of email, but a lot of viruses, a lot of malware comes in through the browser. So what happens if I send you links to something, maybe that's gonna try to phish your credentials or do something else to get you to load that malware itself from the browser?
Well, that's where we have another new capability. It's called safe links. So here in my administrative console, again, I have a safe links policy that is set up for my organization. And what Safe Links policy allows me to do is set up a policy for each individual clicks in my organization. And I can track those clicks as well so that I can later find out who exactly in my organization is getting targeted. And I can also protect them in the real time, because when they try and click their link, it'll open up in a predictive shell, and we'll see that soon.
All right, so I've actually got a mail here that's got a bunch of bad links in it, and a couple of good ones. So I'm gonna go ahead and send that out to you. Go ahead and continue writing and click send. There we go. Now it's already out of my inbox. It's on its way back to Shobit.
Great, and I've logged into my demo account again here on Outlook, and I can see that your email just came in. So let me try and open up that email. So, and I can clearly see there are a couple of links in this email, and you know, and on first sight, they look pretty non-suspicious. It's saying Contoso tax. Let me go ahead and click on that link. Now, what the thing here to note is that this link actually was malicious. The attacker did behind the scenes change that link. And what I'm presented with is a new protective shell. And within the shell, it specifically calls out that, hey, this is a redirected link. It's pointing to spam link. And it's recommending me to not continue. I can if I want to, but as an administrator, I can also block that action.
So this is a completely isolated browser environment, right? So it can't actually do any harm with where that's rendering.
That's correct. We can't do anything. But there are other links in that message which might have been nice. So for example, I can see you also like using Bing. So for example, if I click on that, I can clearly see that I can get to Bing.com without getting that protective shell. Because we are looking only for those suspicious links. So at the time of click, we evaluate all of those scenarios, and then based on that, we provide the right set of tools for you.
So there was some similar functionality with Exchange Online Protection. What's different here?
Yes. What EOP provides is a time of delivery protection, where we are scanning each individual message for any suspicious links. What SafeLinks is extending is providing the time of click protection, because attackers will frequently go back and switch the destination of the link. Mm-hmm. And also on the administrative side, we have another set of new capabilities. So for example, I mentioned I can see exactly who in my company is getting targeted. I can do that from the admin console. So if I go back to my mail flow and come here, and I'll see a new tab called URL trace. Now people in our company generally, or people for Office 365, they're already familiar with message trace. But now with the URL trace, I can track individual clicks in my company. So let's say, for example, we are trying to find data for last 24 hours or last 48 hours, and I know the email was sent back to me. So let me add my email here. So let's choose Shobit. Let's add that. And let's try and run this click trace. And what you'll notice here is all the clicks that I have done in the past 48 hours are showing up on the screen now. So I can see that I clicked on that bad link and it was blocked automatically. I also clicked on a good link and it was not blocked. The another key thing here is that I can double click on each of these individual clicks, and that will lead me exactly to the same message trace that will provide the details of the message that came through. And it's not the click trace that we are extending. We also have reporting available for the type of attachments that have come in. So already in my protective environment, I can see that some of the emails that came through, they were of different types and what actions were applied to them. And at the same time, we also have the malicious types called out. So I can see there were some documents which were PDF, some of them were Word documents, and so on. So it's a really great tool for the admins to find out and discover information.
So a very comprehensive set of solutions. So the system can now be set up to proactively detect and block suspicious attachments, links, bulk email, and really go beyond basic filtering for known malware.
That's right. And simultaneously, we are working on some new capabilities, such as post-delivery removal of malicious messages, and also the rescue of misclassified good emails.
So when is all this coming to Office 365 tenants?
Well, the advanced threat protection capabilities are currently in a private preview with our selected customers, and it all goes to public availability in third quarter of 2015.
Thanks, Shobit. Of course, all this information and more can be found on the Office blogs and on Wednesdays and when news hits on Office Mechanics. Thank you for watching, and goodbye for now. We'll be right back.